How come it's showing my meeting room? Should be.
It's already going live, I think. Showing live on YouTube.
Okay. Hey, Manali.
Hi.
Welcome to Million Moms. It's such a pleasure to have you on Million Moms YouTube channel today.
Thank you so much for inviting me. It's such an honor to be here. And thank you for giving me this opportunity to share with you about pelvic floor physiotherapy.
Yeah, but this is such a dreaded topic, you know, not many people even speak. So I'm so glad you and you as an expert are here amongst us sharing your information, because this is going to add a lot of value to a lot of mothers, because they don't even know that there is a solution available for such a problem.
Yes, definitely. I would share about pelvic floor physiotherapy in detail today. And I'm really hopeful that it's going to help a lot of women, mothers during pregnancy, postpartum, and also women above 60, because incontinence, prolapse is very common in women above 60. So I really hope today's conversation and today's presentation is going to help a lot of women.
I'm definitely sure, because you are an amazing doctor and the way you explain things is really awesome. So Manali, you can get started with the session. Yes. Most women complain of, even when they're exercising, but they don't talk about it to others. When they're exercising, they feel a leakage of urine.
Yes.
Right. So why do you think that happens, Manali?
So I would like to show you this. This is a pelvic girdle, okay? And pelvic flow is one of the important component of pelvic girdle. Mm-hmm. And a woman during childbirth, during pregnancy, there's a lot of pressure, a lot of trauma, which, the pelvic flow endures. And because of that, a lot of women develop weakness of pelvic flow.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? And so I would compare a pelvic flow to like a trampoline.
Right.
And when you jump on a trampoline, you need that firmness in the trampoline, right?
Right.
If you don't have that firmness, what happens? You drop.
Mm-hmm.
Same thing happens with the pelvic organs. Mm-hmm. If there is no firmness in the pelvic flow, in the pelvic musculature, it's not able to stop the involuntary leakage of urine, so that firmness, that tone is required, that strength is required, which is most of the times lost during the pregnancy, postpartum period. Mm. So it's very important that women are aware of, not only aware of their anatomy, but aware what to do about it, how to exercise, how to engage their pelvic flow in the right way. Most of the women, this is a neglected part of our body. You can see a bicep.
Situations where we neglect our physical health. Women don't even take care of their regular health. So pelvic floor is they're not even aware that they can do an exercise for that.
I totally agree. You can see your biceps. You can exercise your bicep. Okay, it's getting weak. You can see your quadriceps. You can exercise. But pelvic floor is invisible.
Mm.
You don't see it, right? So something which you don't see, you don't feel there's a problem in. And right. Even if there's a problem is, you don't know what to do about it. People don't talk about it. I know so many women, who just wear a pad and go about their life. And sometimes when it gets too much, they stop going out. They stop socializing.
Right.
There are a lot of women who do this. And they don't talk about it. But as I started, I've started seeing women as a pelvic floor physiotherapist. They have started, a lot of women come and share the stories about me that they have stopped socializing, they've stopped going out for functions, because of this problem. They get very embarrassed when they leak, and every time it's not possible to wear a pair and go out. Sometimes they miss it, and it's a very embarrassing situation for them.
Right.
But there is a solution to it, and it's very unfortunate that not many people know about it.
Right.
And that's why I'm here today.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Manali. Can you start explaining that in depth? Do you want to share your slides and start explaining the topic to women?
Sure.
So, like Manali rightly said, pelvic floor forms like a trampoline joining the pelvic girdle. And a lot of people do not want to discuss about this. What does the pelvic floor support? It supports the sexual function, it supports the urination, it supports the defecation. So it is a muscle which supports all of this. So having the right tone to the pelvic floor is of utmost importance. And Shiv, you want to explain to us what are the dysfunctions that women generally experience and what are the treatments available for the same and how she is specialized in that subject and how she can help women?
Yes, so can you see me?
Yeah, I can see you.
Okay, so I'm starting.
But I can't see your screen. Put it on share screen.
Yes, okay. Okay, you can't see my screen?
I can't see the presentation.
Okay, one second. Is it visible now?
Yeah, we can see, yeah. You can, yeah. Awesome. So, why did you get interest in this particular topic, Manali?
Yeah, that's a very interesting story. So, I developed diastasis pubis after my pregnancy.
Right.
And nobody had answers to my question that time. That's way back in 2010. And I consulted a lot of people. Even after I was healed to it, I went through a lot of pain and it took a long time to heal. And I asked a lot of clinicians why. But they were like, no, it just happens. It's hormonal. These are the answers I got.
Right.
So as a physiotherapist, my interest, really developed in it. I wanted to know why it happened to me and does it happen? And I was really surprised to know that one in every 800 women experience diastasis pubis. That is, yes, that is a separation of the pubis. This is the pelvis. This is your pelvic girdle. This is how it looks from in front.
Okay? Right.
And this is how it looks from back.
Right.
So, diastasis pubis is separation of this part.
Right.
Yeah. So, that's got me interested, in pelvic health. And being a childbirth educator, it was just an extension of my role, I felt. Mm-hmm. And I could really help. I thought that's how I'm here as a woman's health physiotherapist.
Wonderful, wonderful. Yeah, Manali, can go.
So,
yeah.
I'll start. So, what is pelvic health physiotherapy?
Manali, there are a lot of moms joining us. Mansa is saying hi, Hannah is saying hello. Hello, Sri Lakshmi. Hi, Nagini. Hi, Jyoti. So nice to see you all on the live chat. Yeah, go ahead and share it with different women because not many people talk about this very, very important aspect of pelvic floor. So, because this will be a very, very powerful and informative topic. Hey, Priya, so nice to see you. I know you had gone through certain issues. So, I think we have the therapist over here and she can answer. Yeah, Priya had faced this recently, Manali.
Okay. Okay, pelvic girdle problem. Okay.
Yeah.
I hope this will help you then. So, yeah. So, going further, what is pelvic health physiotherapy? So physiotherapy is rehabilitation and pelvic health physiotherapy is rehabilitation of your pelvis. Pelvis includes your pelvic girdle, the entire pelvic girdle, the bones, the soft tissues, muscles, ligaments, and your pelvic floor, the perineum. So it is a treatment, rehabilitation of your pelvis. So going further, it would help a lot of people, but these are the main categories which pelvic floor rehabilitation plays a very, very important role. One is pregnancy, one is in incontinence, urinary incontinence, and one is organ prolapse. Okay, so going further, in pregnancy, so during pregnancy, as you know, there's a lot of changes taking place in your body, right? Your baby is growing in size, the center of gravity is shifting, your ligaments are getting stretched, your diaphragm is getting pushed upwards. There's a lot of pressure on your pelvic floor. So with a lot of these changes, especially in your third trimester, and if you had a pre-existing problem, it's going to even feel even more during your third trimester, right? So it's a good idea, to consult a pelvic floor physiotherapist who is specialized in treating pelvic girdle. So sometimes what happens is some muscles which you tend to overuse, it could be because of the posture you adopt, or it could be because of the anything, they just go on and they are overactivated. Okay. And some muscles, due to some reason, they go off. You don't use them. Then there is a weakness in those muscles. So a physio would identify which muscles are overfiring or overactivated, overactive muscles, and which muscles are underused, weak, and a specific rehab, if not generic, but a very specific rehab program will be tailor-made for you to address this problem. Sometimes it's like a quick fix. You go to a physiotherapist, the therapist assess you, and some manual therapy, and your problem will get fixed. But sometimes it may take a little more a while. You'll have to have more visits to the therapist. And after some time, most of the time you do feel well. Okay. This is about in pregnancy. Then going further, intrapartum. So I have had the opportunity to support women in labor. And it's also my passion. And this is something I have really enjoyed. And I felt as a physiotherapist, I could really contribute, you know, in this sphere. So if you can see in this picture, during the ancient times, women adopted different birthing positions. Okay. And they just did it instinctively. They didn't know why they are doing it. They just did it. It came from inside. But now with the knowledge of biomechanics, and how joint moves and how joint opens up in which position, we know why they did it, right? And that's the whole role of physiotherapy during labor, as you give birth, you know. If it really helps, because you know if this position will help the baby move in the birth passage in a better way. And it really helps. Sometimes what happens is a woman has a tight pelvic floor and it causes a long second stage of labor. You can really help her with a different position to relax pelvis flow, which will help her to have a more smoother labor, maybe reduce the labor time. So this is something which is very beneficial, and I have really seen it working for sure. Okay. Then postpartum physiotherapy is mainly your fitness. But apart from fitness, there are a lot of issues, you know, which happens during postpartum. I already told you, I faced diastasis pubis, and a lot of women face a lot of other issues. And some common ones I would just list here is one is diastasis recti. And diastasis recti is so common. Out of every two, one woman faces it in pregnancy. That is the latest statistics. And it's so unfortunate that we have a very limited research on this. So diastasis recti goes a long way to cause other problems like weak abdominals, then hernia, then back pain, pelvic floor dysfunctions, which in turn further, you know, leads a lot of complications in the later ages of the woman. So I think if this is addressed at the right time, you would be saving yourself from a lot of discomfort in your later years, right? So I think awareness that you can get help in this condition is very important, okay? And this can be treated for sure. Then diastasis pubis, I have shown some really scary looking x-rays here, but diastasis pubis is a very, very painful condition. Which I've already explained a little bit that the pubis separates here, and the most of important causes is hormonal, but a physio can really help you with the stabilization exercises. You have to understand the biomechanics. Why would this give away? This would give away because maybe at some other joint the movement which is occurring is less. There is hypomobility at this joint. Therefore, this joint is excessively stressed. Right? So you need a detailed assessment why this has happened, and you need specific exercises, specific stabilization exercises to address this problem. And this goes a long way, not only in healing this problem, but also preventing other problems which you will be exposed to if this is left untreated. So going further, Then the various other problems which you can get help in one of is urinary incontinence. Urinary incontinence, the most common type of urinary incontinence is stress incontinence, where you leak urine when you exercise or when you cough or when you just laugh loudly even sometimes, you know. And that's because the weakness of the pelvic floor muscles, and it gets really embarrassing many a times. You don't have control and you have to use pads, and the problem just gets worse. Day after day, and you don't know what to do about it. So the pelvic floor therapy has it's an evidence-based treatment for urinary incontinence. Okay, so then organ prolapse, as you can see in this PPT, the first is a normal position of the bladder, the uterus, okay, and the rectum. This is how you uh, it is if you from the sideline, side view, okay? And you can see the bladder, the uterus, and the rectum are in the normal position. But you, if you see in the second, third, and the fourth diagram, it will show you prolapse of the bladder, urinary bladder, then the prolapse of the rectum, and the prolapse of the uterus. Now, what can you do? How can a physiotherapist help you in the treating this? Okay, we'll understand this as we go further. So before that, I would also like to really emphasize this slide. So not only in pelvic floor disorders, we can also help you in a lot of lumbopelvic related pain and myofascial pain. So a lot of
Manali, can you just stop? She's sharing the screen. We'll just address some questions and come back. There's some beautiful questions.
Okay, sure.
So there's a mom who says even when she jumps or does some exercise, she is observing urine leakage and it causes a lot of discomfort to go for a gym or other fitness classes.
Right. So she just delivered. Which month?
Deepika, how many months is it post delivery, Deepika? Jyoti says even for her she has observed that.
Okay. How many? Yes. Surprisingly, 25 to 75% women after delivery experiences. Yeah. It's a huge number. In the, which month is she in? Can she just...
Deepika, how many months post-pregnancy are you? Same with you, Jyoti. How many months post-pregnancy are you right now? Yeah, Manali, you can start answering the question.
So I think it's a good idea to wait for 6 weeks, okay? After your delivery, for the let the tissues heal and for the recovery, giving your body to heal itself. And the, yeah.
Yeah, Priya Dutta says she had that issue after 3 years of giving birth.
Okay, yes, that is also possible. Okay, so mainly the issue with incontinence, most common type of incontinence, stress incontinence. Which what happens in stress incontinence is your pelvic floor goes weak. Okay, and I just gave an example of a trampoline. That if the trampoline loses its firmness, if you're jumping on the trampoline, what will happen? You'll fall down.
Right.
Same thing, when your pelvic floor becomes floppy, when it loses its strength and in a good flexibility, it just goes down and it is not able to bounce back.
Okay. Right.
Stop the flow of the urine, right? Mm-hmm. Your sphincter needs to contract and your sphincter is also connected to the pelvic floor muscles. So right. That effective bounce back, trampoline-like action is not there.
Mm.
So you need that strength, flexibility and proper muscle recruitment.
Mm.
Which goes, haywire after pregnancy, not necessarily in vaginal birth, more common in vaginal birth, but even after C-section. So most of the people think after C-section, they will not have. No, after C-section, your body has undergone pregnancy. Your tissues have been stretched. So even after C-section, you can have these issues. You have a cut in your abdominal area. So your abdomen, it's weak and your pelvic floor is going to get affected because of that also. So it's not...
Jyoti says after 5 years, she's having...
Yes, it is definitely possible. It starts then during childbirth and you don't realize it. And it slowly goes on getting weak because you slowly keep on, you don't realize, you don't use that muscles, those muscles as it effectively. But you just don't realize because they're invisible muscles. You don't see them, right? You don't realize and it slowly adds on. Finally, when you get the symptoms, you realize, I have this issue. It may have started then, but now slowly... because you get the symptoms, you realize. But the good thing is this can be addressed and it can be cured to a great extent. Okay. And if you take the therapy now, you can stop it from progressing and stop from a lot of other complications happening later in life. Okay. So coming back, I'll be talking about the muscle strengthening and how.
Yes. Other mother is asking, is sex a problem? Is having sex also a problem?
Yeah. So I was just speaking about the myofascial pain. So many times there is a myofascial pain, there is tissue sensitivity, right? And which that's one function. During the internal examination of the pelvic floor, we assess if the tone of the muscle is hypertonic. It's not always weakness. Sometimes it's excessive tone. That can cause pain in sexual functions. So it's not always the problem is muscles are weak. No, half the time the problem is muscles are tight.
Wow. And
yes, and then you have the solution is just opposite. You have to relax those muscles. You could teach them how to relax those muscles. You first identify those muscles, get them to understand where the muscle is. okay, through an internal examination. It's only possible with an internal examination because from outside you can't see these muscles. And then you identify the muscles, identify the source of pain, and teach the mother how to relax the muscles, how to let go of the tension. We store a lot of tension in our pelvic floor. See, you know, when you tighten your jaws, you also tighten your pelvic floor.
Totally.
When you tighten your shoulders, you also tighten your pelvic floor. Every time you get anxious, every time you feel anxious, you tighten your pelvic floor. So we all store a lot of tension in pelvic floor, and a lot of women have hypertonic, excessive tone as a major problem rather than, you know, weakness. And yes, and that has to be addressed in a separate way altogether.
Awesome. So can you go ahead with the myofascial pain slide?
Yeah, sure. So yeah, so I just spoke about myofascial pain. It could be because of a scar tissue. It could be because of sensitivity around the perineal area. So through internal examination, you understand what is the cause through observation, examination. What is the exact cause? And you treat accordingly. There are a lot of hands-on techniques like myofascial release, trigger point release, manual therapy techniques, which can help immensely, you know, in lumbopelvic pain and myofascial pain both. Now going further, pelvic floor. So as you can see in this slide, in the first diagram, you can see this here, the pelvic floor is weak, okay? And it is not firm. But you can see in the next diagram, the pelvic floor is strong and healthy, right? So you require a healthy pelvic floor to support the organs and to prevent incontinence and issues like organ prolapse. As you can see here, in the second diagram, the pelvic floor. The pelvic floor is essentially like a sling, okay? It's like a sling. It starts from here. So this is the pubis. It starts from here and it ends here. So it's like a sling and your organs are sitting on it. Urinary bladder, uterus, rectum, they're sitting on it. If it is not firm, okay, then it will not be able to support the organs. So the function of the pelvic floor is extremely important. Going further, so as you can see, pelvic floor, I have shown you, is like a hammock. Okay, it's like a hammock. You can see in the first diagram, it's a toned pelvic floor, so which gives a good support to the organ. And you can see in the second diagram, it's a droopy pelvic floor. It is not giving a good support to the organ. So when you have droopy pelvic floor because of weakness, because of surgery, childbirth, numerous causes why you can have, you know, a droopy pelvic floor, it can give rise to problems like prolapse, urinary incontinence. Okay, so going further. So what does a pelvic floor physiotherapist do? So the pelvic floor physiotherapist will, how is it different from normal physiotherapy? So in normal physiotherapy, we assess your joints and we prescribe the treatment accordingly. So even in pelvic floor physiotherapy, first observation, then assessment of your joint will be taking place. You'll be seeing your lumbar joints, your sacral mobility. After that, what is different here is there is an internal examination. Okay, and the pelvic floor will be assessed by an internal examination. By the internal examination, we'll be assessing the tone of the muscles. That is, if the muscles are weak, if there is the hypertonic, if there is excessive tone in the muscle, or if the tone of the muscle is reduced, then we'll be seeing for the sensitivity, if there's any sensitivity around it. And we'll be also seeing the your ability to recruit the specific muscles, if you're using the right muscles or not. So everything will be assessed through an internal examination. And we use Oxford scale for grading your muscles, right? And after we have assessed you, we'll be giving you a treatment, the excess prescription for pelvic floor. Now, one thing which I want to really highlight here is Kegels is not the only thing. So I think Kegel is the most overused terminology. So everybody thinks pelvic floor is equal to Kegels.
See, a lot of people here, they don't know what Kegels is also. Down south, people are not even aware of Kegels. Forget about it being overused. They're not even aware of Kegels.
Okay, but even if you know many are aware
You
of
take up the share screen and share it because it's very, very important, I feel, for you to talk about that.
sorry acha about the kegels.
Kegels, yes.
Sure. Okay, so yeah, so anybody has any specific question about kegels? Do you want to ask anything specific about kegels before I proceed?
Yeah, so what is kegels? Because women are not aware that there is an exercise called kegels.
Okay. So kegels basically is a pelvic floor exercise where you use your pelvic floor muscles. Okay, it I think it's very important to teach women how to engage their pelvic floor muscles, and it has to be taught along with the breathing, because your pelvic floor doesn't work in isolation. It works as a unit with the diaphragm. Diaphragm is a muscle that's below your lung. Okay, so it works with synchrony with diaphragm. So I think it's very important to teach women how to engage their pelvic floor when they breathe, so that it becomes a habit and it becomes easier to learn and you know use in the daily life. So pelvic floor exercises is basically engaging. There is a muscle group called as levator ani. Okay, and your pelvic floor is, I already explained this, there's a sling. It is like a sling. It starts from the pubis and it goes to the coccyx here. Okay, and it helps in providing support to the organs, right? If your pelvic floor is strong, it gives a good support to the organ. But if it is not, then you start having a lot of issues which we have already discussed about. You can engage the pelvic floor exercises by doing exercises like kegels. How to do kegels exercises? So the practical way of doing kegels exercises is, simplest way, if the patient is not in front of me, I would say, let's just imagine you're passing urine and you have to hold, you have to stop your urine. What would you do? Just tighten your pelvic floor muscles, hold for some time and then let go. It's the simplest way of explaining. But many a times what happens is they don't understand which muscles to use. Most of the time they use their adductor muscles, adductor the inner thigh muscles, or they excessively use their abdominal muscles. They don't use the pelvic floor muscles, okay? And that's why it is very important that you go personally to the therapist and you learn how to engage these muscles.
Right. So Deepika is saying post-pregnancy, urine started leaking. She is a dancer, but because of this problem, she has to use pad even in non-period days. She couldn't continue dancing. She was watching on YouTube. Can you tell her it's not YouTube that's going to help, but she has to reach out?
Yes, definitely. Deepika, right?
Yeah, Deepika.
Hi, Deepika. I think definitely you have to reach out to a pelvic floor therapist and you to understand your anatomy better, the pelvic floor anatomy better, so that you adhere to the exercise program. Once you understand how it works, it'll be very easy for you to adhere to the exercise program. That's why information about the pelvic floor, how it functions, is also very important. Along with learning how to do exercises. Because if you just learn how to do exercises, you may not do them. Because I think it's very important to understand the importance of doing the exercises, engaging the right muscles and using it in the right way. So I think reaching out to a pelvic floor physiotherapist will be definitely a good idea. Yeah.
But there are not many pelvic floor physiotherapists around, right, Manali? Even normal physiotherapists, they're not aware of these exercises. Mm-hmm. So what do you think? Why is it that people are in the most important area, we don't have women helping other women?
I totally agree. There are a lot of physiotherapists, but very few physiotherapists who are specifically, you know, into women's health therapy. And I really don't have an answer to your question. I don't know why.
But as far as you know, how many pelvic floor physiotherapists are there?
Very few. I personally know maybe 10 in India.
Yeah, throughout India.
Yes, maybe. Yeah. I don't know. Maybe there are more. But I'm sure in the metropolitan cities, at least Hyderabad, there would be one or two pelvic floor therapists. And
so Priya is asking if the pelvic floor is weak or tight. In both cases, is the treatment the same, or can be told only after examination?
So I think in that case, it's a good idea to understand how your pelvic floor functions and to try doing the Kegels exercises by the explanation I have given you, like just tightening and relaxing, how I've told you. If it that is not, and you see for the results, okay, you wait for 3 months, you wait for 2 months, and you see if you're getting results, if there is improvement in incontinence. And if you don't feel there is any results, then you go ahead with, you know, then you will have to reach out to a pelvic floor therapist. So first, to understand, so what I meant was just to give you a summary of it. First, to understand the how it functions, and try to do with this information on yourself, tightening, folding, relaxing, and see if it functions. Because many women also get it right. It's not that everybody does it wrong. Many women also get it right.
And, they can reach out to you, right, Manali, if they have any issue. Because Priya says because of lockdown, she was not able to contact the doctor. Would it be possible for them to reach out?
I'm available on teleconsultations as of now.
Okay. So you have a Facebook page where they can reach out and message you?
So I'll post it on your page, maybe in the link below. And they can definitely reach out to me. So I can educate them more about their pelvic floor and show them the various options, what they can do. Till the time this lockdown is there. And after that, I would encourage them to go out and reach out to the therapist, because that's definitely required and there's no two ways about it. Yeah.
Sure. So do you want to continue with your presentation?
Yes, sure. Can you see the presentation? Can you see the presentation?
Yes, we can.
Okay.
Put it on full screen. Yeah.
Yes. Okay. So,
yeah, it's there.
I spoke about how pelvic floor physiotherapy is different because it involves internal examination. And that's what makes the pelvic floor physiotherapy is different from other physiotherapists, because apart from observation, examining the joints, you have to be trained. You know, it calls for a separate training in internal examination. So once a physiotherapist undergoes this training, this physiotherapist can help with pelvic floor physiotherapy. Going further, treatment. I've already spoken about this, Kegels. That Kegels is not the only thing. There are a lot of other things. There may be some issue in the pelvic girdle. Okay. There may be hypermobility. There may be hypermobile. So all this problem, the woman has to be treated holistically. The focus only should not be on the pelvic floor. I'll give you an example. So I had this woman who had an incontinence issue. And whenever she told me one specific thing, that whenever she gets up from the bed, she leaks. Okay. And I asked her if she has any knee problem. So she told me she has osteoarthritis of knees. Okay. So it shows that because of the weakness of the knees, you know, she has to use her abdominal excessively, and that increases her intra-abdominal pressure. So along with pelvic floor physiotherapy, she has to also be given strengthening exercises of the knees, right? So you have to treat the person as a whole. Okay, so that's very important. And Kegels is not the only thing. I think it's also important. A lot of women have pelvic floor tightness. The treatment here would be teaching the woman how to relax the pelvic floor using a lot of manual therapy techniques. The treatment is customized and it's very specific and non-generic to everyone. Okay, then adjuncts. So usually we use adjuncts like biofeedback, electrical stimulation, and vaginal cones, which can be used in certain cases where muscles are very weak. Like some women have muscle strength of less than one, or they're extremely weak, and you know, with digital therapy, you don't see results, and women are not able to isolate their muscles. So in such cases, using electrical stimulation, biofeedback, vaginal cones gives them that extra sensory feedback, and they're able to engage the muscles in a better way. Okay, so I wouldn't suggest using biofeedback, electrical stimulation in all the cases, but if required, they should be used, right? And lifestyle counseling, of course. And general fitness, diet, bladder training diary, all this plays a very important role, you know, as a part of physiotherapy. And this is something which they can follow, even if they are, you know, right now, especially during lockdown time, if they are diet, fitness, you don't require to visit a physiotherapist for that. This can be advised online also, right? So, yeah, going further. So, sorry, you're mute. Dr. Pavitra, you are mute, I think. Can't hear you.
One more question. Deepika is asking, is it because of natural birth that she's having? I don't think that's the case, right? Even in C-section, mothers can have.
Yes. So, see, when you are pregnant, your tissues get stretched. okay, and there is a lot of changes, a lot of changes are happening in your body, and even during the natural delivery, your pelvic floor undergoes a lot of pressure, a lot of trauma. So one of the causes of, you know, pelvic floor dysfunction or you know, having incontinence is childbirth. But it's not necessary that, you know, only vaginal birth causes the dysfunction. Even after C-section, a lot of women experience incontinence. Yeah. Okay. So going further, so there's a lot of evidence. There's a lot of evidence suggesting that everyone who is having incontinence should be offered pelvic floor physiotherapy for first 3 months. And this should be the first line of treatment. Okay, the EUA, that is the European Urology Association guidelines, says so. Then the Cochrane review says so, that first 3 months you have to try out pelvic floor physiotherapy before considering any kind of surgical options. So it's definitely worth a try. And 5 sessions, mostly in, I've seen personally in incontinence cases, 5 hands-on session of physiotherapy is mostly what it takes, you know, to give a good amount of cure or a good amount of relief in cases of incontinence. Yeah. So going further, now the takeaway message. So what is the takeaway message from the session? So pelvic health therapy can be taken during pregnancy and birth. Pelvic floor affects your core strength and your respiration, both. Okay. Women with organ prolapse should be offered physiotherapy. Pelvic health physiotherapists have been specifically trained to assess and treat pelvic floor dysfunctions. Not all physiotherapists do pelvic floor work, right? Ask your healthcare provider about pelvic health physiotherapy before you consider a surgical option. Evidence shows that urinary incontinence responds very effectively to pelvic floor physiotherapy. And lastly, but Kegels is not the answer to all your pelvic floor problems, right? So yeah, so thank you everyone. So any, please, if you have any questions, you can leave in the comments below and I'll be glad to answer them. I hope the session was helpful and thank you so much. Hello, yeah. So we have.
Yeah, go ahead, Dr. Mani.
Yes, we have just concluded the session. If anybody has any questions?
So get off the share screen so that we can talk to the others.
Sure.
So Deepika says, urine tightening and releasing slowly exercise helped me to a lot, but it seems to be a temporary solution. Is this something we need to continue daily?
Yes, so she needs to do it every day for like at least, you know, 3 months. And at least, yeah, that's very important. She does it at 3 times a day and at least 10 contractions at one go and continues it for 3 months. And then maybe slowly reduce the frequency. So it's not something you do for 2 weeks and leave. You have to continue to get the results. And along with the pelvic floor exercises, it's also important to do core strengthening exercises. Because as I told you, pelvic floor doesn't work in isolation. It works along with your breathing, how you breathe, if you're holding your breath, if you're holding a lot of tension inside. So you're strengthening and then just you're doing the things which you're not supposed to do, everything is going in vain. So there's a lot of other things, how to breathe, how to engage your muscles on daily basis, your posture, how do you sit. So a lot of things matter.
Wonderful. So Priya says it's a super awesome session and she thoroughly enjoyed it. Thanks to all the mothers who are watching. This is a topic which most women do not want to talk about. They do not even share with their friends. So I request you guys to educate women. There is a solution for all of this. There's nothing to worry. It is not a lifelong thing. But you need to reach out to the specific therapist, like Manali. Like Manali, there are very few people across India, not even on fingertips, you know, not even in hundreds. They're just in tens. So reach out to these therapists and work with them so that you can improve the pelvic floor health. And it can be easily treated. It's just a matter of identification and getting the right therapy or treatment for the solution.
Okay, I would like to add to this. You can just check out my page, The Cocoon, on Facebook. I write very frequently about pelvic floor and, you know, women's health. So I share a lot of good information there. And I'm sure it can be a lot of value to you.
Yeah. So moms, go ahead and check out The Cocoon. Follow her if you have any pelvic floor issues, and refer anyone that you know, refer to her directly, because not many people are even aware, not many doctors are aware. So Chandana is saying, is it genetic, ma'am? She's asking if it is genetic.
So see, the collagen tissue, the tissue structure, the content of tissue can be genetic. Yeah, but that is something you can't do anything about. What you can do about is your muscle strength that you can build on, and that can make a lot of difference. The quality of your tissue can be genetic, that's what I'm saying. But the muscle strength is in your hand. You can build up by exercising regularly, following a good diet, you know, by having a good fiber diet, avoiding intake of colas or excessively sugary drinks. And you can maintain a good pelvic health by exercising regularly. So you can do a lot of things proactively.
Right. So Priya says that she stopped jumping. After starting with Kegels, there is little jumping, there is no issue, but she stopped jumping. What do you think? Should they stop jumping, Manali, or how should they handle
it? Not at all. She should not stop jumping. She should just address her pelvic floor issue first. She can continue with Kegels right now. So she was saying that she got relief. That means somewhere she's doing something right. I'm sure she's doing that. That's how she got relief, right? So continue with Kegels. Don't give up. Continue. And also start a core strengthening exercises along with Kegels. Focus on how you breathe. Make sure you're taking deep inhales. When you inhale, you're relaxing your pelvic floor. Okay, and when you exhale, your pelvic floor is coming back. Make sure you're breathing in the right way. Make sure you are having proper body ergonomics. Make sure you're having a good diet, good fiber, not straining excessively, good water intake. And and slowly, as you build up on your core strength, I think you'll be able to jump as many jumps as you want. Yeah.
Right, so Chandana is saying, is the frequency higher in vegetarians?
No, there is no, as of now, there is no evidence for that. And there is no correlation between being vegetarian and having incontinence or a pelvic floor dysfunction issue. There is no, excuse me, there is no correlation. Yeah.
Okay, so Chandana had a grade 2 cervical prolapse and she's 20 days postpartum. When should she start exercising?
She had what prolapse?
Grade 2 cervical prolapse.
She had grade 2 prolapse. Okay. And she's how many days postpartum?
20 days postpartum.
Okay. So she can start doing Kegels right now. I would suggest start engaging your pelvic floor, you know, the way I told you, as if you're holding your urine. And start doing Kegels at least maybe 3 times a day, hold for as long as you can. And there are 2 ways of doing Kegels, tightening and leaving it for the fast contraction muscles, twitch muscles, and tightening and holding it for 10 seconds and then moving it. Do it every day, at least for 10 contractions in one go, and do it 3 times a day. And continue doing it. You'll have to see a pelvic floor physiotherapist if this issue doesn't get resolved on its own after 6 weeks.
Okay, wonderful. So Hannah is saying, very beautifully explained.
Any other questions?
Guys, any other questions or should we wrap up? How about resuming running is what Chandana is asking.
After normal delivery.
Yeah, now she's like 20 days postpartum.
Yes.
Would running cause more prolapse? Would it enhance?
She has prolapse, right?
Yes.
Okay, so I wouldn't encourage running right off as of now. So we have to see how the prolapse, you know, if it is reducing or if it is increasing, you have to wait and see. You practice Kegels, start off with Kegels, slowly start engaging your abdominals, work on your core, and slowly as the condition improves, maybe slowly you can get on to walking and then running. But we have to see how the condition goes on. It has to be monitored. For right now, I will not say start running right now. No, you have to see if you have this issue.
Okay, so Chandana, no running immediately.
Yeah, and she will require internal examination.
You need to rest or work on your pelvic floor on your abs. Yeah. Okay. So any other question? Anything that you want to suggest? So do you like the lives and the experts that we are getting in to speak on different topics? Yeah, she's saying thank you so much. Chandana is saying thank you. She's a periodontist. She's a very very, very disciplined doctor that I know of. So Manali, so let's come back to your personal life. So tell me, how have you transformed over the years? What are the practices that you do which have helped you deal with life?
I think the credit goes to Dr. Mani Pavitra. I met Dr. Mani Pavitra when I attended Lamas session with Dr. Vijaya, I think 2017. And I don't know, I think she did some magic. And I got so passionate about Lamas and women's health physiotherapy. I think I'm doing today, I would like to give the most of the credit to you and Dr. Vijaya, because you have helped me immensely, not only with the subject, not only with, you know, childhood education, but to evolve as a person, to understand life better and whatnot. So I see, I'm totally thankful to you. Yeah.
So Deepika is saying, you look gorgeous and beautiful. She's thinking you're unmarried, it seems, Manali. You should show your daughter.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. Deepika, that is what happened.
I love
that women take care of themselves. Manali, can you show your daughter? Is she around you?
She's not here right now. She's just gone on a terrace. If she comes,
so how do you manage to look so gorgeous? You tell people the secret.
I think I did a gratitude course from Dr. Mani Pavitra.
Oh my God.
You enroll for Dr. Pavitra's gratitude courses. That is the ultimate secret. I mean it with all my heart.
Oh my God. I wanted you to tell some other secret, okay?
Other secret. Everything boils down to this. For sure. She's my greatest inspiration. Yes, absolutely.
No, but you are also helping me. The kind of work that you're doing, I'm so proud of you, because we really need these people. We really need more women like you, Manali.
Thank you.
Yeah, because it's like together, I think the women, all of us should specialize in different subjects and help women out of their, you know, I feel it's not reaching out to the right people for help. You know, it's all about, they think too much in themselves and they don't reach out to people for help.
Yes, absolutely. Maybe they don't know whom to reach out.
Exactly.
Maybe they don't know that there's help available. I think that's the most of the women who come to me, they have this explanation that we don't know that this is a treatment. Forget normal people. I would say even the medicos are not aware of this domain of physiotherapy. A lot of medicos. So if I think the main thing is to make the medicos aware, mainly the gynecologists. I think we need to have awareness among gynecologists that the people who are suffering can be referred to a pelvic floor physiotherapist. I think things will start changing from there.
Right. So mothers, if you like this, go ahead and smash the like button, because, you know, as you all know, topics like this should reach out to as many women as possible, and especially to doctors. If you know any doctors in your circle, like Manali is saying, if you know any gynecologists, do share this with them, because, you know, it's always a teamwork. When a doctor refers to a correct pelvic floor physiotherapist and they work on the, like, together as a team, there's so much more that we can do. Together as a team, we can help out a lot more women, right? Like, I truly believe in teamwork. I truly believe in women supporting each other and enabling others' lives. I feel we're all born to help each other, you know? So I think we should all, if you know any other gynec in your circle, do share this video with her, so that, you know, pelvic floor therapists need their attention. It is a definite branch which which they can handle it so beautifully. I've seen Manali over the years, the way she does it is like phenomenal. So if you know any gynecologists, do share this video with them so that they know that even in India we have. A lot of people think in India we do not have facilities, but we have people like Manali who are specializing in subjects like this and they're doing amazing good. So guys, go ahead. If you like this session and if you like our lives, go ahead and hit the like button and share it with gynecologists specifically in your circle. Okay. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Manali. It's such a pleasure talking to you.
Same here. And thank you for having me here. Thanks a lot. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. Bye, guys.